My name is Rhapsody, and welcome back to Slay the Spire. Ooh, the Heartbreaker runs. Wait a second. Defect is... Yeah, Defect is definitely on 20. I don't know why it reverted back down to 15. Yeah, Defect's definitely on 20. Oh, these are also the Heartbreaker Chronicles, obviously. So we're doing High Ascension, trying to get past the heart. Rare card to obtain for 18 or upgrade a card. Probably upgrade a card, actually. We can get a 3 upgrade path with three question marks, as well as 4 question marks and late shot. That seems pretty good to me. Upgrade the zap and then dual cast in that order. This path also has the ability to deviate later on if I decide to go for an extra elite or if I decide to go for fewer elites, plural in that case. Countable set, so it's fewer. All right, defend, zap, defend. Nice. Get that out of here. Barrage versus Cold Snap versus Stack. I'll take a Cold Snap early. That's value card. Yikes. Unfortunate turn. Just have to take 10 damage. Don't really have any choice. Yup. Fairy in a bottle as well as Blizzard. I mean, we've already taken a Cold Snap. Blizzard isn't good yet, but it gives me license to take a lot of Frost Generation cards past this point, which I'm kind of on board with already doing. It lets me take worse Frost Generation cards in particular. Cool. Recursion can be used to generate, quote unquote, a frost there. Or it could actually just take Compile Driver as double draw. Compile Driver. Yeah. Still the best I could have defended that turn. I was hoping to draw, I guess, Zap there. And we take 6 damage. 6 damage from that takes them to... 37. 37 is still above their split value. 37, 35, wow. Whew, can't count. That's okay. Got him. Loop versus Charge Battery. I really want Charge Battery, but Loop is particularly good in a deck where you're going to be stacking Frost. Okay. First Elite's going to be rough. Pretty good opening hand, though. Do I let the 24 kill me and then try and block the next attack? I think so. Kills me for perfect damage. No, I'll block. Great. So now we die to this attack, get revived with 7 HP, and thank heck we had that hand. Woo! Happy Flower, every 3 turns gain an energy, as well as a Hyper Beam that I would really like to be able to take, but I understand that in the late game it's going to be very difficult to win if I don't have any focus. Turbo Scrape, no thank you. Yeah, I could have gone for extra question marks here, but obviously I need to duck off and rest. At the very least, we know our next elite can't be the same again. Wow, no defense that turn. I know I haven't drafted many defensive cards. I mean, trying. I've been trying to balance drafting defensive cards with drafting cards that will help me win. Attack potion. That's definitely a leap right there. Thank you.
It's the Singer Ball!
When adding cards to your deck, you may gain 2 max HP instead, or raise your max HP by 2 instead. Yep. We'll be taking that, naturally. In this position, we will rest yet again. We've got one elite off to the side, and then we've got another position directly after that'll be a lot better. Zap or Cold Snap, or do we actually open up the damage this turn? I think it's actually probably open up the damage this turn. We have full orb slots already. It's basically as good as it gets. Triple defend, we've still got the lightning orbs dealing some damage for us at least. That has to be a dual cast just due to the amount of raw damage it gets to put out. I'll take Barrage here. Recognizing the Barrage is about to get a lot worse. Never mind. I should not have taken Barrage there. That was a mistake on my part. Two for each channel dwarves. Great. 6, 10. Oh, we have exact lethal. Whew. Auto Tornado. Upon pickup, choose a power card. Start each combo with that card in your hand. Go for the eyes for some weakness in the deck, and then I'll put the loop on top of my deck. Obviously, got a rest here as well. I'm hoping this shop has some sort of frost generation. If this gives me the decay, I can just remove it in the next space, thankfully. Ooh, that's 100 gold. We could actually pick up a pretty great relic here. Oh! Damn! Calipers in a Frost Orb deck is ridiculous. So is Data Disc. Chemical X is obviously ridiculous as well for the possibility of having the reinforced body. And Defragment is also pretty ridiculous. Like, all of these are really, really, really good. I'm worried that I can't take Calipers as much as I desperately want to, because I don't yet have the Frost generation. And I think that if I take it for the short term, for the long term benefit, I probably die in the short term. This deck isn't yet powerful enough. So I think it might have to be Defragment, Charge Battery, Data Disc. And Barrage. We need a way to deal damage. Which this deck is sorely really lacking at this point. Okay. Should be able to upgrade another thing here. Defragment upgrade is pretty ridiculous. Okay. Ow, this is gonna hurt. Okay, so 18, 22, 30, 34. Yeah, we're fine. Whew. Good thing we could put the enemy on the ground there, because we did not want to take that damage. Hey, first Cold Snap is in the very bottom of the deck, unfortunately. That is the worst position for it to be in. Because obviously we want as many Cold Snaps as is humanly possible. Awesome. I don't want to redraw any of those, so I'll play the Compile Driver first. That should have been Dual Cast Zap there. Should have been dual cast zap. I'll dual cast here, actually, because now I can get the frost to the front of the party. I could have done that before, but ew, I messed up. Blizzard still doesn't really deal any damage. So we just get 10 block. 5 block at the start of each turn. We will get 10 block at the start of each turn. when we have the frost upgraded correctly. Sorry, the loot upgraded correctly, rather. Okay. Barrage, compile driver, looking to get back to barrage, but we'll use Blizzard for the kill. Fission. Definitely fission here. Yeah, easy. Damn it! What is with the game and not giving me energy relics recently? I swear. God. All right, well, I need more frost, so I have to take the orrery and take card selections. Loot versus cold snap. I actually really want the loot, but I guess I take the cold snap there. Wow, these are some really bad options. All right. Taking the max HP there, take the cold snap here. I know I didn't want to, but I had to. Because we didn't get energy in the previous space, we need some more zero costs in the deck to help us defend. So I'm thinking we take a steam barrier. We'll take two. And then a sweeping beam to provide a little bit of AoE to the deck. This is not good. We really needed more out of that, and it just was not willing to provide. I dual cast there so that I can get the extra block out of the frost orb. Okay. Because now the frost orb is at the front of my party and it's giving me 5 block at the start of each turn. Yeah, I'll use fission here. My hope was that I would draw my cold snap, but that's okay. I'm not going to play the steam barrier here. Only saves me 1 HP, but it would downgrade the steam barrier for the rest of the combat. Ugh. All right. Now it's time to win. Great. Strength pot as well as recycle doom and gloom reprogram. In this deck. Enchiridion. I'd really like Enchiridion. Necronomicon, the first attack you play each turn that costs 2 or more is played twice upon pickup contain a special curse. Okay. Might get something going on with that. Probably don't want to put Jax in this deck. The HP loss is pretty harsh. The extra damage on turn 1 doesn't really matter to this deck. We don't really deal our damage that way. We're not particularly aggressive like that. I think I actually may transform 2 cards. Just transform a strike and a defend here. In order to try and get some cards that better fit our build. Wow, a Blizzard and a Sweeping Beam. That provides more AoE. The deck has actually been looking for that. Yeah, I'll take the Relic. Frozen Egg. Whenever you add a power card to your deck, upgrade it. That is very powerful for us. The reason I took that... Oh, heal 15? No. Glacier. It has to be Glacier. Chill is really good in this deck as well. Especially in AoE fights. I'm going to take Chill. Go to the next position and upgrade it to become innate so that it's actually before either of our... Wow, I can't believe we didn't end up with any more money, but actually I can because it was unlikely that we got it. Cool-headed versus another Chill. I'll take the second Chill actually here. Thorns potion definitely in this fight. Probably the strength potion as well. I don't think we're getting through this combat, actually. but I'm gonna give it my best chance. Ow. Okay. Play Fission here for the extra draw, fragment. Great, great, great. So we get to recreate a lot of our block here. Alive by one. Oh, thank you, Loot, for the extra block. Don't think it's going to be enough, but thanks for trying.
Yeah, we did.
That was a lot closer than it really had any right to be, specifically because it was the Book of Stabbing. If it was either of the other characters, the Slavers or the Gremlin Leaders, both of those chills would have been far more effective. That's a lot of the reason that I took the chills, is because AoE fights on that floor were going to be particularly punishing for us. Enemies in extreme combats have one. It's possible to get one elite, I guess. No, I'm gonna take the curse. Okay. Emotion chip. Whenever you lose HP, trigger the passive ability of all of your orbs at the start of your next turn, and then I'm going to remove the normality from my deck in two spaces time. Especially because the base deck, you don't play more than three cards per turn anyway. Until you at least upgrade one of them. Being Zap or dual cast. Genetic algorithm this early? Totally. Damn it. Explosive as well as a leap for defense's sake. Probably normality removal and self-repair. Alright, I'm gonna go with upgrading because I really need more offense in this deck, and being able to play Zap every single time that I draw it, it's pretty good. We're in Ascension 20, so because of how much you need in Ascension 20, not only to win Ascension 20, but also to beat the HUD or even stand a chance, I'm gonna try and give myself the best possible chance by taking a lot of risks early. Eh, we got the core face, that's okay. Damage here, but I heal 7 and get an upgrade on my genetic algorithm there. Obviously cold snap. I'm gonna dodge this first elite. Very hopeful that I get like self repair as well as. Aww. Lame. Great, that worked out perfectly. Self-repair, genetic algorithm, and now I can kill the enemy. I need to try and play both of those each combat. If the eyes is value pick for weakness, shuriken obviously. That just made the go for the eyes pick a lot better as well. Shoot! Fine. No, no compile driver there. Recursion stack, nope. Dodge the extra elite. Yeah, we have a shuriken. We need to dodge elites for a little bit more here. Transformer defend. Overclock? Okay. Yeah, we'll see how much of a place we can make for that in this deck. I guess when the deck gets thick enough, it won't be a problem. Barrage versus Heatsink. Well, Barrage is a great damage delivery mechanism when we have a bunch of extra strength from the Shuriken. And I do have some other cards that I desperately want to upgrade. Sunder, obviously. A zero energy Sunder, I mean, obviously. Okay, strike, strike 24. No, it's got to be Barrage, strike 24. Whee! Hoping that I get better defense this turn. Reasonably good defense. Could have been better, could have been worse. Okay, we do have a cold snap in the next hand, so we know that we've got the kill on the backliner at least. Wow. Wow, that turn ordering. If I played Sunder first, I would have won. Like, instantly that turn, I would have saved myself 8 HP. Good gosh, Ryan. Yikes. Whetstone upon pickup upgrade to random attacks. Another barrage. Those barrages are a considerable part of our damage, so very much worth upgrading them as early as we can. Okay, those are basically the best opening turns that I could have gotten here. Like, because most of the rest of my deck is defensive. Because of how much we rely on barrage for our damage, I'm not going to dual cast here. I will, however, dual cast here for a much better split. How? Definitely go for the eyes on the target that I don't intend to kill. Actually, we'll do the draw first. Great. Meteor Strike versus Multicast versus Machine Learning. Probably out of these, Machine Learning. So we can draw extra cards per turn, try and get more of our zero cost attacks, so we can try and funnel all of that back into the Shuriken. Extra energy so I can play extra attacks, especially extra attacks, extra cards drawn by the Machine Learning, and the Overclock is a really good idea. Busted Crown versus Runic Dome. I'm going to take the Busted Crown. Just because there are certain enemies in the game, Tangela, Spaghetti Monster, whatever you want to call them, Writhing Mass is their actual name of the game, that can just completely dunk on you if you don't know what their intents are, and their intents are random. Okay. Ooh, that's not a great opening draw right there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're just gonna lose a bunch of money. Ow. Oh, It's gonna be like zap double barrage for the. Okay, sure. Thanks for that. Charge battery, definitely want that. Mercury Hourglass at the start of your turn, deal 3 damage to all enemies. Very, very, very powerful. Unfortunately, I can't put any of these enemies on the ground. I can triple target the same enemy, but it won't do it.
Ow. Ow. Ow!
Had to put that specific one on the ground there. Didn't want to take that 14 damage. Okay. And now we've got the win. But that came at a large cost for us. Another charge battery, sure. Probably the last one I want to take there. No. Having another bad opening hand is just a recipe for death for us. I don't think we're powerful enough to take on any elites this floor yet, which is mortifyingly sad. Okay. Something tells me that extra energy next turn isn't going to be particularly handy. That's a lot of damage. I can't kill this turn though. Ow. This is why I didn't go for an elite, by the way. Second self-repair. I'm gonna need it at this rate. I'll rest as well. As much as I want to be upgrading cards, I also don't want to die in the next combat. I know, weird, right? I'm gonna use a skill potion here, looking for draw. We did not get any draw. That's mortifying. If I played that earlier, I would have gotten a little of extra damage from the bash. Sorry, from the barrage. Okay. So far, a lot of this could have been better, but gosh, it could have been worse. My 14 heal at the end of this combat. Thank you. Another hologram. Another hologram. Sorry, our first hologram. Yep. Got a fair wealth of cards there that I'd like to pull back. Duvu Doll versus Sapphire Key. Duvu Doll is actually already 1 point of strength for us. Strength is very nice for this deck. Data disk. Start each combat with one focus. Thank you. We've got amazing relics right now. It's just about trying to keep this alive while we find something to get completely broken in this deck. Because decks don't win this mode by being good. Ascension 20 going for the heart. Dex win this mode by being broken. Okay. We don't need extra charge batteries. We probably need a little bit of extra draw at this point. healing 14 at the end of this combat is always going to be nice. Okay, boss at the end of the floor is the champ. I was about to double check that, but I remember. I knew that one. Like, I'm trying to plan around the champ. Cool. Yeah. Probably too many holograms. Not too many. Probably enough holograms at this point. FTL... I really want to go, like, FTL, Skim, Glacier, Core Surge. Yeah, Core Surge and Skim. Would I take Storm? I have... 2 powers in the deck. How likely am I to pick up more powers? 3 powers in the deck, sorry. Pretty likely. Defend, hologram it back so I can defend again, and now we're perfectly defended. Sorry, leap. Leap. It's leap. Look. La leap. The leap of the revolution. Should have played Core Surge first there. Yeah. No reason not to. Could have prevented some incoming damage. Oh, I did prevent a lot of damage this turn, or rather I did try, but... Thankfully we had that one covered ourselves. I will actually dual cast here, try and keep as much HP as possible. Yeah, that'll get that done. All for one. All for one in this deck would literally be used to pull back our zero cost attacks, like FTL, go for the eyes. I guess Zap and Dual Cast both come along, Overclock comes along. It wouldn't be a claw deck. It would literally just be to try and fund our Shuriken. I think that's probably still a good thing to do. I can't go for that extra elite. I think that I'm probably going to take a bunch of damage in that final combat on this floor. So I think I'm upgrading this Storm so that I can guarantee that it generates 4 lightning over the course of a battle at least. Or 3. 3 currently. All right, that's a pretty good opening turn. Point of strength. Okay. I'm gonna hologram back the all for one, then play it. Mm-hmm. I don't really intend to get to my next shuffle, but that's another point of strength for us. That blocks 5. This blocks giant bunny ears. More. Okay. I'm gonna hologram back the genetic algorithm and then kill just so that I can play it. Re-upgraded charge battery though. No. Deck has enough defense. We're gonna have to get all of our stars on the final floor. Stars. It's not what they're called. Both of these holograms need to be upgraded though. Using all for one literally just to get another zap out there is extra damage, but I don't care about my damage. I care about the ability to ramp up my shuriken. Thank you. It's too early to start adding burns to my discard pile, frankly. This fight is going to go very long. I'm going to cycle through my deck multiple times. I can't afford that this early. Right, I'm actually going to pull out the Go for the Eyes. That gets me a point of strength, but it also weakens for two extra turns. Very nice. Great. Mm-hmm. Unfortunate that All for One is constantly turning up in our first hand, but that's okay. We've got the energy as well as the hologram, so we can pull it back. I actually don't want to zap at this point. I want all of my frost orbs. Really? The bottom card of the deck is hologram. I wanted to draw the hologram there so that I could use All for One in order to get all my zero cost cards back. That's remarkably poor. I'm actually a little astounded by it. So Overclock is fine in this deck, I guess? Oh, wow, really? There we go. Now we'll pull back. All for One. Yeah, cool. There's your purge. That's a lot of damage, my friend. I play the extra zap there to evoke the frost orb. The overclock is going quite well. It's just that I can't play it in this kind of a combat. Which is fine. Not every card is for every combat. You take extra cards for certain combats and, you know, not for certain other combats. Right. I could have easily used a fear potion at some point in this combat. I just don't think it was really necessary. Energy potion, all right. Well, ethereal form? Ethereal form playing two attacks, or, gosh forbid, playing two copies of self-repair, or two copies of Glacier, or two copies of machine learning, or even two barrages, is pretty ridiculous. We'll be taking it. Frozen Core replaces Cracked Core. If you end your turn with any empty orb slots, channel a frost. We haven't got another energy option here, so, you know, that's really sad for us, but eh, whatever. I'm going to take the Frozen Core. So now my goal shifts to generating exclusively Frost Orbs. So Zap is now a very weak card in this deck in particular. Did play Zap. That's okay. So now actually the most important thing for this deck now is gaining extra orb slots. Woo, yes. Very glad that happened. Remove 22 damage from the field. Hell yeah. Yeah, probably not Sunder for this deck. Actually, was that Sunder pre-upgraded? If it was, then I could see it. Hmm. I decided to use my extra energy potion there. And that's because it's very important that I start getting these exploders down, lest they destroy me. Great. So I wanted to try and get that off to as early a start as I possibly could have gotten. I may actually just wait here. Actually, 7 healing is already enough to win. Play that genetic algorithm twice. Hell yeah. Full heal. Another cold snap, yeah. We want to generate frost orbs and we want to attack, so cold snap is totally up our alley. Second storm is really powerful though. Frost. Frost with focus is really, really good as well. I want the focus. And another zero cost attack, but a zero cost attack that applies vulnerability, especially considering how much damage we deal on our zero cost turns. Well, on certain zero cost turns at least. That could have been better, but it could have been worse. Okay, only 5 damage. That's really good. Pretty good turn for us. Shouldn't have played the zap. Playing that zap meant that I didn't draw an extra card with the FTL. It's okay, though. And then I hologram back the All for One, play the All for One. I mean, that's a pretty effective turn. So this isn't really an All for One deck, it's a deck that happens to have and utilize All for One quite well. Dual casting is usually a good idea here because it allows me to start generate more things in the frozen core, rather. Yes, that was misordered. Could have done 7 more damage. I was focusing entirely on trying to defend myself. Dual cast, hologram back the dual cast, and then win. Compile driver? Yeah, okay, it's pre-upgraded. Fair bit of damage. Writhing Mass, okay, we've got to play more cleverly around this because we have had some very bad interactions with this character. As much as I could have attacked an extra time that turn, I elected not to. That's a parasite. It literally adds a parasite to your deck. But that parasite is 1 point of strength for us. There's a possibility that it is better, because the deck is quite thick, to just allow the enemy to add a parasite to our deck. Specifically because the other things the Writhing Mass does are very damaging. I'm not going to allow them to do it. Okay, nice. That turned out to be good. Oh, great. That's just, I am definitely taking a parasite now. Well, I'm glad that I found a way to mentally justify it beforehand, because it went from giving me a parasite to giving me a parasite, and I didn't really have a say in that. Oh, well. That is a lot of incoming damage, my friend. Okay. More than happy to have that. Definitely self-repair, machine learning, old core surge as well. The extra attack does nothing here. The core surge just prevents the weakness? Oh, I wanted it to prevent the vulnerability. But then again, I would, right? Good. Gosh. This thing is just really rough. Yikes. Yep, another go for the eyes for the weekend. Boss at the end of the floor is awakened one. Okay, so I probably don't want to pick up that many powers on this floor, but that's okay. Curse of Writhe, as well as a little bit of HP. If our opening hand didn't have a storm in it, which isn't going to do anything on our first turn, I would be more likely to take a Curse of Writhe for an extra point of strength there, but we don't, and it isn't. So, I'll take some Madness. If I can hit those on... I'll recall here as early as I can as well. Loses strike easily. War paint. I have to take the sapphire key though. Okay. If we can hit those madnesses on all for one and in particular all for one and the name of the other one. Name of the other one. Name of the other one, Ryan. All for one and the other one. Then we would be in a pretty good position. Damn it, Core Surge! You had to turn up now? Ouch. Hologram. Hologram. I meant hologram, obviously. What do you mean I don't get credit for it because I had to have it as an afterthought? What do you mean I'm talking to myself? And then hologram brings back all for one. You can see why this is a really powerful thing. And that's only hitting it on a hologram. I would have liked to stick it out in that fight for a while so I could try and heal, but it doesn't look like that was in the cards for us. Giving myself a bunch of extra energy next turn so that I can try and draw the skim and actually get a really good effect off, because this is going to be a really rough fight otherwise. We get 6 block by playing the Cold Snap, or 9 by playing Leap. Take the 9 and Echo Form there. I play the Echo Form here so that I have the possibility of duplicating the effect of our the effect of our self repairs. Because if we can do that, we can actually heal 28 at the end of this combat, which would be nice, right? Just think of it. Huh. Nice, right? Anyway. I'm intentionally not allowing myself to draw this turn, by the way. Because I'm trying to wait for these self-repairs. Gosh, damn it. Really? I need them to be in different hands from one another as well, which is probably the hardest part. All right. I'm going to hologram a Glacier and a Skim. I'm going to play the Skim. Really? I played that so I would have the extra chance of finding a self repair that turn so that I don't get both in the same hand. Never mind, we didn't get both in the same hand. All is good and right with the world. So we double our self repair next turn and then kill. Heals for 28. All lightning, no. I have to go for this leap, otherwise I don't get to go for the heart. I mean, that's a pretty good first turn. Those aren't really the cards I was intending to hit with the madnesses, but yeah, I'm okay with it. Echo form is obviously going to be a great... missed the awful one. It's okay. And we've already played one of the self-repairs, so we can dual play the next self-repair, which is nice. Double on FTL. Then we use a hologram to bring back all for one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, too many cards in hand. No, I still play it first. Great. Then I can... Barrage, barrage for a pretty ridiculous amount of damage there. Ooh, that's not good. I'm actually tempted to double machine learning here. Yeah. Provides extra defense that turn by popping up my frost orbs. And also makes my next hands much more... powerful. Okay, I'm gonna double cast Leap. Dual cast, and then Hologram to bring back the All for One, and now it's All for One's turn. I get to double play self-repair. I'm going to be pretty happy about that. That doesn't look like we will be able to, though. Okay. Double the overclock. The zero-cost cards we can get back are pathetic right now. It's our only hologram in the deck as well. Ouch. Yep, this is the kind of turn I was looking for. There goes the giant head. We get 14 HP. Dreamcatcher, whenever you rescue Matter Cards to your deck, as well as Capacitor. Thank you. Ow. It's not a great fight for us. Zero cost skim is really good. I'll play that zero cost skim again, thank you. Zero cost draw three. Whew. All right, we'll be burning Echo Form. Really can't afford to use it in this combat. Playing self repair gives us the full defense. Very hopeful for a barrage next turn. Didn't get it, so that exploder is going to blow up, but I only need to defend for the incoming 30. Throw away that potion just for the earlier kill, especially because I don't want my entire deck to just become dazed. For Right. I don't need to attack at this point. I can actually just wait. Right. Power potion as well as another hologram. Yep. Those holograms are ridiculous in this deck. We have to rest here though. As much as I want to upgrade the holograms, we have to rest. Pre-upgraded Sunder. No. There's so few enemies that we kill beyond this point, right? It's bosses and elites. Obviously the cultists, but the cultists don't count. It sucks to not be able to play Glacier this turn. I probably don't play Storm in this deck, but Echo Form is really important. The amount of block that Echo Form is going to provide for us is ridiculous. Defragment. It's similar for the Defragment, by the way. It's going to provide a ridiculous amount of block for us. So is this fight going to be worse, or is Donu and Dekka or Time Eater going to be worse? Time Eater is probably worse for us. So for that reason, I'm not going to be using the Focus Potion in this fight. I'll be saving that for the next. Yeah, forgot that I had Dual Cast up by there. By the way, there, rather. A lot of damage dealt, my friend. Oh, zero cost hologram is dangerous.
Danger, danger. High voltage.
I will Machine Learning and will All For One, because both of those are really important. Also, Capacitor is going to get played in this combat as well, but probably later. Is there anything else I would pull back? No. Okay, that's 40 incoming. Let's use Capacitor there, double as well. We'll hologram back the All For One. Enemy is already weak though. Leap, All For One. Brings back the charge battery. Good. I desperately needed it to do that. We've got a lot of defense set up now. Damn it, those two self-repairs had to turn up in this hand. I'm not going to be able to play them. Pile driver for the extra draw. I'm trying to get to my next deck so that I can start playing those self-repairs, by the way. No, I should probably play one now while the enemy is down. Obviously, charge battery as well for the extra energy. Gotta remember, I duplicate the first thing I play next turn. There's a genetic algorithm. 15 by 7. Well, 15 by 14, actually, right? But the thing is, I can play the genetic algorithm later anyway. I was gonna guess 225, but I didn't want to, you know, stake my claim on the maths. Take 2 damage this turn. I'm legitimately waiting for my self-repair. Okay, we get the double play self-repair there. Now we'll go for the kill. Heals 21 at the end of that combat. Time Eater. Cool, this is the worst combat we could have, so it's focus potion time. Got 2 damage that turn, but I get 10 block as a result of it. This leaves me with ability to play 4 cards next turn if I play this extra strike. Or 5 if I don't. 4 is more likely. And I'd hate to only be able to play 4 cards. Yeah, I'm only able to play 4 cards this hand, so it's important that I played an extra card last turn. Do I barrage, then madness, or madness, then barrage? Like, what do I want madness to hit, effectively? Leap or barrage? I think I want it to hit a defensive card so that I can bring that defensive card back a lot more. Okay. It's very painful that turn there. Woo! Didn't make me vulnerable. Nice. Okay, this leaves me with the ability to play 4 cards next turn. That debuff, though... No, we'll be able to play 4 cards next turn. The debuff the enemy is putting on me is a lower draw limit, so I just need to make sure that I draw 4 cards that I can play. Is that 4 cards that I can play? I mean, it is, but... It's painful. I think if I play Echo Form right now, I die. That's the problem. Damn it. If I play Echo Form, I will definitely lose. That's really rough. Echo Form is so powerful, and to miss out on it is really, really difficult. So I don't get to really do that much this turn. So I just need to set up as best I can. Because I can't kill the enemy this turn. So do I want to charge battery or up my strength? I think I want to up my strength. trying to manage the amount of cards that we play per turn so the enemy doesn't go buck wild all over me. I can literally only get a dual cast currently. I think I'm now dead. Right? May as well do what I can. Oh, three. Okay. Never mind. We've got a little bit more life left in us. A little bit more life to live. I'll use the FTL first before the beam cell, just because I want the extra draw. Never mind. I don't get the extra draw. I got to remind myself that I don't have Echo Form out. Seven rough. The only way we live this turn is by drawing and playing Go for the Eyes. There it is. 42. Yeah, we're still dead. Ah, died to the second boss in Ascension. Well, not the second boss, but the second end boss. Look how few relics we had. That was rough, but still pretty damn good. That's a pretty damn good run right there, in my opinion. Not every run has to win to be good. For the moment, my name has been Rhapsody. The name of the game has been this episode was probably late. Sorry, my bad. Hopefully you've been enjoying yourselves, and hopefully we'll see you next time.